Good morning, I'm Dr. Nemechek, and I want to talk to you about heart rate variability, or otherwise known as HRV. This is a very, very important measurement. We're going to find it has increasing importance over the next decade. It's going to be a huge factor. Your doctors are going to be measuring this on a regular basis. They're going to have newer EKG machines. They're going to measure this. And so I think it's about time you figure out what this thing is and how we can use it today. So HRV, heart rate variability. First, what does that mean? So some people think it means like how much your total heart rate goes up and down, and that's not correct. What it means is how uneven the heart rate is. So your heart does not beat like, you know, the metronomes for a piano. It is not even like that. Between each beat, you want to have some variation in time so that each pair, so you have a pair of beats, and then the next two, make my fingers look better here. There we go. The next two might be longer apart, and the next two might be skinnier apart. And so you have this variation between each successive pair of beats. Now, if somebody's heart, for instance, is beating 60 beats a minute, that is just a mathematical average, all right? Really, what's happening is their heart is beating, instead of one per second between two beats, they might be 7/10 of a second. But then the very next two beats might be 1.2 seconds apart. Then the next two beats might be 1.1 and 0.9 and 0.85 and 0.12 and so on and so forth. So that little time between each of these is varying back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. That's the variability in heart rate variability. Now, the more variation you have up to a point, or having good variation, I should say, is a healthy thing, all right? The closer and closer that variation decreases and becomes, say, closer to the one beat per second, if you have an average of 60 beats per minute, is a very dangerous thing. All right, it's a sign of brain weakness. The brain, your nervous system is not able to have a resilience to respond to your physical threats, environmental threats, manage your emotions, hormones, organs, all that kind of stuff. So how do we measure this? Well, you can actually measure it with an old-fashioned EKG machine if it was doing the calculations. So each little beat on your EKG rhythm strip that the doctor will get, there is software that can calculate that. Now, most doctors don't have that software, okay? We will soon be coming out with a device that you can measure this on the phone. We're probably, I don't know, that might be available this summer of 2018. It's called My HRV. And what's the purpose of measuring this? Well, you think of measuring your heart rate variability as kind of like measuring your blood pressure, okay? A lot of people have a blood pressure cuff. It's a way to manage your health. It's a way to understand what's going on with you. And it's a way to understand measuring HRV is a way to understand what's going on with your brain. Alrighty? Now, as I've talked about in my post and another video called Inflammaging, all right? There is this increasing level of inflammatory chemicals in our bodies called metabolic inflammation. The higher it goes, the older you are, the more aging you get. So we call it inflammaging. And this is a really, really important thing. This triggers most disease. It triggers most cancers, heart disease. Without this, you couldn't really get Alzheimer's or Parkinson's or diabetes. I mean, super important phenomena going on. And we can measure this inflammation with your heart rate variability because the inflammation worsens heart rate variability, all right? And actually what happens is the inflammation's damaging your autonomic nervous system and mainly your parasympathetic branch that runs through the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve is the longest, most exposed nerve in the body. And these elevations of these inflammatory cytokines with inflammaging damage it. And that is reflected in, you got it, your heart rate variability. So by measuring your heart rate variability several times a week, even daily, it takes 1 minute to do, you can see where you are with inflammation. And now, so say you want to fix your intestinal bacteria, add more fish oil, make sure you got the right kind of olive oil, whatever you want, special diets, exercises, yoga, Wim Hof, cold plunges, whatever you want to do, you can monitor its positive effect on the inflammatory system as well as your brain with something as simple as what's called HRV or heart rate variability. So I hope you found this useful. This is Dr. Nemechek at Nemechek Autonomic Medicine, the inventor of the Nemechek protocol, and have a great day.